Hello, everyone. Today on Good Morning Maine, Bangor officials have ordered residents of a local homeless encampment to leave today or face the consequences.
Plus, several Maine communities are receiving grants to make improvements to help local residents.
And a special career fair was held in Castine to help students land a job at sea.
Good morning and welcome to Good Morning Maine. I'm Emma Smith.
And I'm Craig Colson. Thank you for joining us. We'll have those stories coming up, including a live report from down at Camp Hope in Bangor, where they're getting ready to remove that homeless encampment. We'll be there all morning long to tell you about that. But first, a check of the forecast. It looks like a pretty nice day ahead today. Partly cloudy skies, kind of warm for this time of year.
Yeah.
Overall, not too bad.
Yeah, a beautiful day in store. Here's Devin Biggs with that forecast.
And thank you very much, Craig and Emma. Happy Friday. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Blind Faith Tattoo. With over 25 years of experience, we are fluent in all styles, including traditional and fine line tattoos. Stop by for a free consultation from one of our friendly expert tattoo artists. We offer a fast turnaround and walk-ins are always welcome. Let's get into things this morning. And again, watching clouds are developing. Maybe a few returns, maybe some showers in the northern parts of the state as well. We'll watch for a little bit more development to the south coming up later on today, as all of us will get in on the action coming up later today, and especially overnight tonight with a decent amount of rainfall on the way over the next few days. I'll need to keep an eye on from this system to the south and this system off to the west as well. Both of these will be moving in our direction. So future cast for today, increasing clouds, some showers possible late in the afternoon, and we'll have better chances for rain overnight tonight, especially into the daytime tomorrow. And for the winds, not too bad from time to time, roughly out of the south at around 10 to 15 miles per hour sustained, with gusts up to 25 miles per hour possible in a few spots. We'll see that back off a little bit later on tonight, but it might pick up a little bit again, especially as we head towards Saturday afternoon. So for today, lower 60s, mostly cloudy, some afternoon showers, and a south wind getting up to around 25 miles per hour at times. Overnight time, middle 50s for the overnight low, rain likely, areas of dense fog can't be ruled out, and an east wind at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Hourly forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period, a lot of clouds. We had showers late in the day with temperatures in the 60s. Your full five-day forecast is coming up. Craig and Emma.
Thank you, Devin. The city of Bangor has posted notices throughout the Hope House homeless encampment, mandating certain individuals to leave the area today. People living in the encampment and members of the public are now struggling with many questions. Our Devin Dagnall is there now, but first let's check in with the latest from yesterday. Excuse me.
Thank you, Emma and Craig. As was said before, many people are being forced to leave their homes here in Tent City, while others are being allotted more time while they figure out a new living arrangement. Our Grace Blanchard spoke with those being moved and city officials yesterday. Take a look.
For numerous Mainers, the encampment behind the Hope House and Living Center in Bangor is called home. However, the city of Bangor recently posted a notice along several trees at the encampment saying their time there is ending.
Nobody's actually came out and bluntly said, you know, you're out here tomorrow or you have this much time left. So we're all kind of like, we don't know what's going on.
Chris Reynolds has been living in the encampment for a little over 2 years and says the notice has left many concerned and confused.
I'm still kind of taken aback by it. I don't really even know what to say right now. People got campers here, they can't even get those campers moved. And all their possessions are in that.
According to city officials, those who have refused to engage with outreach services are being asked to leave. Officials went through the encampment this week, placing X's to indicate those who have made efforts to connect with services and are reportedly not being removed on Friday.
Nobody really even knew at first what the X's on the tents even meant. There was like green ones and orange ones and red ones, and they're doing anything and everything that they can to just get people out of here. Basically just kind of like hide the problem or push the problem off somewhere else.
Local advocates have raised concerns with the city's efforts.
So the city, I think, was right in going with the strategy of taking time, building trust, working with people over time. But now that strategy seems to have shifted back to move along.
We reached out to the city, and although the city's manager, Debbie Laurie, was unable to speak on camera, she has released an official statement. In the statement, she said, quote, every effort will continue to be made to support the individuals who are being asked to leave the location without disrupting the lives of those who will remain. A thoughtful, methodical process has been undertaken by the city and its partners to ensure those being asked to leave have received proper notice. Laurie says on Friday morning, city staff, along with community partners, will be on site to assist those being asked to leave. She says, if necessary, criminal trespass orders will be issued.
Not bad people. We just, you know, a lot of us you know, tough times.
In Bangor, Grace Blanchard for ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Things are still quiet here in Tent City. None of the city officials have shown up yet, and it appears everyone here is still asleep. We'll keep you updated as we find out more. Back to you, Emma and Craig.
Thank you, Devin. Yep, moving on. We'll hear more from Devin as the day goes on and people show up to clear out the encampment.
All right, in other news now, the director of the Maine Ethics Commission says he does not think there are sufficient grounds to investigate claims made against Senate President Troy Jackson. A request for an investigation was made last month by Representative John Andrews, a Republican from Paris. He cited allegations made by the Maine Wire, a conservative-leaning news outlet. The Wire posted an article in August regarding Jackson's purchase of an Augusta home back in 2019 while representing Northern Aroostook County, raising questions about if he violated the legislature's residency requirement by living in the Augusta home as his primary residence. Jonathan Wayne, the director of the Maine Ethics Commission, issued a memo on Tuesday regarding the guidance office of the Maine Attorney General's issues to legislators, saying, quote, that they may live temporarily outside of their district provided they have sufficient ties to the district and intend to return there, end quote. We reached out to Senate President Jackson's office, who issued the following statement, saying, quote, the commission staff's recommendation speaks for itself. It is consistent with our understanding with the law, and President Jackson looks forward to the commission meeting next week, end quote. Representative Andrews had the response to the director's memo, saying, quote, the Ethics Commission hasn't even met yet, and they've cleared Troy Jackson of any wrongdoing. It would appear that all Mainers are equal, but some Mainers are more equal than others, close quote, end quote. The Maine Ethics Commission is scheduled to meet on Wednesday, October 25th in Augusta. You can bet they'll bring that issue up again then.
That was a lot of quotes.
A lot of quotes. Whew.
Okay, moving on. A tractor-trailer truck carrying Maine dairy cows crashed in Connecticut. The semi-truck was carrying 44 animals Thursday morning when it crashed on an Interstate 84 exit ramp. Rescuers arrived to find the rig on its side. The driver was not seriously hurt, but 14 cows died in the crash and another six had to be euthanized. The remaining 30 cows were loaded onto another truck and taken to a veterinarian for evaluation. There's no word on where in Maine the cows originated.
Well, the U.S. Coast Guard is launching a major operation across New England today. It's called Operation Safe Flight and is aimed at improving safety on commercial fishing vessels. All six of Maine's Coast Guard stations will be supporting the operation. They'll be boarding vessels today all along the coast to conduct checks on safety gear and to review training that will improve survival rates if someone ever falls overboard. Over the last 10 years, there have been 41 reported man overboard accidents, which resulted in the deaths of 23 commercial fishermen.
A man who allegedly killed a person in Augusta and then fled to Mississippi has been indicted by the Kennebec County Grand Jury. 34-year-old Andrew Redman of Augusta was indicted for murder. He's accused of killing 34-year-old Tyler Robinson of Augusta on July 28th. Robinson was found unresponsive on the side of Old Belgrade Road. According to court records, Redmond and three other men allegedly lured Robinson to a location. One of them allegedly tried to force him out of his vehicle at gunpoint. The document states Redmond then allegedly followed him on an ATV and shot him. Police arrested Redmond in Mississippi. The grand jury also indicted an Augusta man charged in connection with defacing a law enforcement memorial in Augusta. 39-year-old Justin Larrabee of Augusta was indicted for criminal mischief and aggravated criminal mischief. A spokesperson with the Maine Department of Public Safety says the memorial was defaced during the early morning hours of May 28th. Larrabee was also charged with another vandalism incident in Augusta that took place a few days following the incident at the memorial.
Well, the Pittsfield Volunteer Fire Department is mourning the loss of one of its members who passed away on the MCI track on Tuesday, firefighter Zachary Noble. Noble's obituary confirms he passed away from a cardiac event on the field Tuesday. Pittsfield Volunteer Fire Department Chief Bernard Williams says his crew was called to the scene to help administer CPR on an unconscious individual, not knowing at the time that it was Noble. Chief Williams then had to relay the news to Noble's family, something that shook the family to the core.
Those words come out of his mouth, and I was devastated, just total devastation.
Family is now looking to set up a scholarship in Zach's name that will pay for the training of young men and women who are looking to get into the EMS program. It's still being set up, but anyone interested in donating should send a check to Chief Williams at 115 First Street in Pittsfield, Maine. Just contact the fire department there. They'll be glad to tell you what you need to do. He was a member of the fire department there, worked in other local towns, grew up in the area, went to MCI.
Just 27 years old.
Tragic.
Yeah.
Tragic.
Very shocking. Yeah. All right, the time now is 6:10. Coming up next on Good Morning Maine, a big announcement at the Grow Smart Summit that will help Maine communities make big improvements. We'll have the details.
But first, another check of your weather forecast. A partly cloudy day ahead today with highs near 63 degrees. Mostly cloudy overnight with lows dropping down to the upper 40s. Tomorrow, a mostly cloudy day with a chance of rain on your Saturday. The high, 64 degrees.
I got rear-ended at a stoplight and needed surgery, and the insurance company tried to give me this tiny little check.
This tiny little check won't even cover my car repairs.
After a car accident, don't take a tiny check from the insurance company. Call the Twos.
I said no way to this tiny check. I called the Twos, and Lowry & Associates got me $300,000.
I'm Jim with Lowry & Associates. Call the Twos. We win for you.
If you're hurt in an accident, what do you do? Call 222-2222.
It's another exciting year of high school football in the state of Maine. Get out and support your home team and be looking for the ABC7 Sports Blitz crew. You can get a free Sports Blitz t-shirt, then watch Sports Blitz during ABC7 News at 11 every Friday night during the football season. Blitz shirts courtesy of the Bangor UPS Store, Berg Activewear, Bangor Tire Company, Bucksport Regional Health Center, Coastal Auto Parts, Complete Tire Service Incorporated, and Electrify Maine.
Where have you been known to strip your clothes off?
At work.
Get wild with Family Feud. New episodes this fall.
You saw their dogs attacking yes. your sheep.
We chased the dogs all the way to his property.
Why don't you keep your dogs tied up?
My dog's never done nothing like that.
There are seven dead sheep.
Hot Bench.
Friday at 3 on ABC 7.
Welcome back to Good Morning Maine. It was 5 years ago when Foxcroft Academy moved forward with a plan to put solar panels on the roof of the Jim Robinson Fieldhouse. In recognition of the project's completion, those close to it officially cut the ribbon yesterday in front of the school's faculty and staff. The Fieldhouse is perfectly situated to receive sun from the east and west. The solar panels will help generate renewable energy, not just for the academy, but the RSU 68 school district as a whole.
We'll produce energy credits, which will be used to reduce our rate for electricity, at least 15%, and does the same thing for RSU 68.
The Jim Robinson Fieldhouse is home to the Academy's athletics, including the Ponies Field hockey and soccer teams, as well as other community activities. Shorey hopes this will be the first step in healing the district, or in helping the district reduce its carbon footprint.
Good news for them. Well, many community leaders from municipalities across the state were in Waterville on Thursday, attending the 2023 Grow Smart Maine Summit. Our Augusta Region reporter, Corey Bouchard, was also there.
And we help communities navigate change, looking at both immediate needs and long-term, and that's the magic of smart growth.
Nancy Smith is the CEO of Grow Smart Maine, a statewide nonprofit organization that advocates for policies and projects that advance Maine's business and economic development. On Thursday, Grow Smart Maine held their annual summit at the Waterville Opera House, part professional conference, part networking event, all with one focus.
Our focus this year is on creating places for connecting people and really diving into the epidemic of loneliness and what can happen at a community level to help people connect.
To continue that focus, during the summit, the United States Department of Agriculture's Rural Development announced a grant of over $300,000 to help Grow Smart offer a capacity building program called Building Community Strength, which Smith says will provide key funding for 10 Maine communities.
It might be programming, it might be the way that the structure of the downtown. It's a fascinating way to really dive into the topic.
For a list of the 10 communities receiving the grants, you can visit our website, in Waterville. I'm Corey Bouchard for ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
Home sales decreased during the month of September. According to Maine listings, they dropped by more than 25% compared to the same month last year. The statewide median price increased by more than 14% to $376,750. Waldo County saw the biggest jump in prices at a 16.5%. Carmen McPhail, the president of the Maine Association of Realtors, says, quote, "Our advocacy efforts at the Maine State House and local town halls are focused on the production of additional housing units. Whether through new construction or adaptive reuse, we are focused on creating a more balanced market in regard to supply and demand."
Kind of a mess out there right now. I've been shopping around, loosely shopping around for the last year or so, and there's just, one, there's not many houses, and the ones that are there, they're just too expensive. I don't know how most people are even affording to, or even thinking about getting a house these days.
Meanwhile, national statistics point to a rise in foreclosures, so it's like, okay, let's... Yeah.
Yeah,
what's the deal?
We need a fix somewhere along the line.
Yeah. So. Okay, the time now is 6:16. After the break, the biggest event of the year was held yesterday at Maine Maritime Academy.
And it's not your average career fair. Details on that and more as Good Morning Maine continues.
Maine has the best shipbuilders in the world.
But to compete, we need reliable and affordable energy.
That's why we're voting no.
No. On question 3.
It will cost Mainers billions and increase costs for families and businesses like Bath Ironworks.
Like Bath Ironworks. And the politicians, they're not even required to have an operations plan when they take over. We'd never do our job without a plan.
Please vote no on question 3.
It's a bad idea for Maine.
Coming to Cross Insurance Center in Bangor for the first time ever. The all-new Hot Wheels Monster Trucks Live Glow Party. Watch your favorite Hot Wheels Monster Trucks light up the floor, including Bigfoot, Mega Rex, and many more. And don't miss the debut of the all-new Hot Wheels Monster Truck Gungster. Plus the dazzling dance party, laser light show, and more. And save up to 50% on kids' tickets. Don't miss this one-of-a-kind Hot Wheels experience. October 20th through 22nd at Cross Insurance Center in Bangor. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com.
It's another exciting year of high school football in the state of Maine. Get out and support your home team and be looking for the ABC 7 Sports Blitz crew. You can get a free Sports Blitz t-shirt, then watch Sports Blitz during ABC 7 News at 11 every Friday night during the football season. Blitz shirts courtesy of Irish Collision Center, Coastal Auto Parts, Comfort Shoes and More, Fogbrook Resort, Four Season Floral and Gifts, Hometown Health Center, Huff Power Sports, and Tip Trailer Grocers.
Welcome back, everyone. Maine Maritime Academy students charted a course for their futures on Thursday during the return of an annual event. Our David Ledford brings us the story.
It's a great time to be a student at Maine Maritime.
Hundreds of students came out for the 23rd annual Fall Career Fair at the Maine Maritime Academy. The event is designed to give students a head start in the maritime industry, with networking, internship applications, and job offers all taking place under the same roof.
This is the biggest event we do all year. There's so much electricity, the students get psyched about coming. They bring their resumes in and get them tweaked and all dress up. We offer the photos, the headshots.
Students say the fair is also one of the many ways the school provides hands-on training opportunities.
A lot of students aren't really sure what they're preparing for. So you go with one of the companies that's like behind me here, and you go and get real world experience with a company, but it's a great opportunity.
Recruiters say the event helps more than just the students.
Many of them come on long term. Many come back to school and they talk to some of their classmates and tell them, hey, went to Hornback Offshore, really loved it, it was a great opportunity. The word spreads.
More than 100 companies from across the country and the globe stop by to show what they have to offer.
There's a lot of people here that want MMA students. There's a lot of companies here, there's a lot of options in a lot of different fields.
Thank you. Thank you.
In Castine, David Ledford, ABC 7 and Fox 22 News.
They're all getting ready to set sail on some big adventures themselves. That will help them with that. I have a cousin who graduated from there. Now he works on these big container ships and they go all over the world. He's gone for months at a time.
But yeah.
He's having quite the adventure doing it.
Right. Yeah, yeah. You can get a merchant marine job really quick out of school.
Yep.
It's one of the only schools that kind of guarantees you a job.
Right. Yeah, no problem.
Yeah. Good for them. Okay. Time now 6:20.
Let's get a full look at our weather forecast.
All righty, Craig and Emma, thank you very much. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Blind Faith Tattoo. With over 25 years of experience, we are fluent in all styles, including traditional and fine line tattoos. Stop by for a free consultation from one of our friendly expert tattoo artists. We offer a fast turnaround and walk-ins are always welcome. All right, let's get into things this morning. And again, clouds will move again, mainly from the south going toward the north and also from the west going toward the east. Maybe a few returns in the northern parts of the state too, with maybe a few showers that could be developing in a few areas. We'll be watching for more chances for showers a little bit later this afternoon, but especially overnight tonight. Let's break this down right now. We have all this activity right here with this system right about in here, tracking from the west going toward the east, and another little system right about in here that's going to be tracking off towards the north. And both of these combined will give us a decent amount of rainfall, possibly up to 2 inches of rainfall over the next few days before we're all finished up. Let's break all this down with Futurecast. So clouds will be on the increase today, maybe a few peaks of sunshine from time to time. Later this afternoon, the evening period, the rain starts moving slowly but surely, with better opportunities for rain as we head after midnight towards tomorrow morning. So a lot of rainfall will be on the way. Some heavy downpours cannot be ruled out either, but notice a few breaks from time to time too before another wave gets going as we head towards Saturday evening. And that will also continue into parts of Sunday morning as well, as that area low pressure continues to track off towards the east. As for the rainfall, it looks a little bit like this. So between now and at least Monday morning when this all wraps up, maybe up to 1 to 2 inches of rain before we're all finished up, maybe locally up to 3 inches of rain in a few spots. So maybe some flash flooding in a few areas before we're all finished up. Make sure you're watching for that through the weekend time frame. Otherwise, though, gusty winds as well, reaching up to around 25 miles per hour at times this afternoon. It'll actually back off a little while overnight tonight, but as we head towards tomorrow afternoon, gusty winds up to maybe 20 miles per hour will be possible yet again, especially later in the afternoon period for your Saturday. Our average high temperature is 57 degrees. We'll reach for the lower 60s today and also tomorrow. We have 50s on the way Sunday into Monday, with middle 50s at that point, upper 50s Tuesday, and lower 60s as we head towards Wednesday and also in your Thursday. For today, lower 60s, mostly cloudy, some afternoon showers possible, and a south wind getting up to around 25 miles per hour. Overnight time, middle 50s, rain likely, areas of dense fog possible, and an east wind at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's tomorrow, lower 60s, rain likely, some morning fog as well, and an east wind at around 5 to 10 miles per hour, but the winds will start to pick up later in the afternoon period as well. Here's a look at your extended forecast brought to you by Blind Faith Tattoo. So rain likely again for your Sunday with highs in the mid-50s. We'll remain in the mid-50s for your Monday with a lot of sunshine. And mostly sunny again for your Tuesday, highs in the upper 50s.
What can your John Deere compact tractor do? Attachments for any job. Financing that's as easy as,
like, getting a library card.
Affordable.
You're going to get this bigger tractor and it's going to be less money.
Dependable.
Through the rain, through the snow, I'll work through it all.
Comfortable.
And I haven't any idea how we survive without it.
Experience united and build a tractor package customized for you.
Lately, we've all had to do more with less. At Chevy, we just want you to do more. So we continue to make affordable vehicles like high-tech SUVs, our strongest, most capable trucks, and the most affordable EV in America. It's how Chevy helps you do more for less.
Current qualified lessees can get this Equinox for $269 a month. Visit your main Chevy dealer.
I got rear-ended at a stoplight, and the insurance company tried to give me this tiny little check.
Don't take a tiny check from the insurance company.
I called the twos, and Lowry & Associates got me $300,000.
Call the twos. We win for you.
It's another exciting year of high school football in the state of Maine. Get out and support your home team and be looking for the ABC7 Sports Blitz crew. You can get a free Sports Blitz t-shirt, then watch Sports Blitz during ABC7 News at 11 every Friday night during the football season. Blitz shirts courtesy of Maple Lane Farms, Engstrom's Auto Service, Foxcroft Academy, Loyalty Inc., McCusick Petroleum, Riverside Grill, Rowell's Garage and Car Wash, and Whitney's Variety. The Farmer's Table in Corinna brings you outstanding breakfasts, lunches, and dinners made from farm-grown fresh ingredients. Dinner specials are available every day. Enjoy our homemade desserts, and above all, bring your appetite to the Farmer's Table in Corinna.
You're watching ABC 7 Bangor.
President Biden made his case for the U.S. to back Ukraine and Israel in a time of war. He'll be asking Congress to approve billions in support. One Republican senator, however, says money can't fix all of the problems for the war-torn nations. Fox News correspondent Carolyn Shively is in Washington with the latest.
In only his second speech from the Oval Office, President Biden said the U.S. is facing a moment where the decisions we make today are going to determine the future for decades to come. As Israel battles Hamas and Ukraine fights off Russia, President Biden spoke from the Oval Office Thursday night, asking for billions of dollars in military assistance for the two nations.
To support our critical partners, including Israel and Ukraine, is a smart investment that's going to pay dividends for American security for generations.
At least 32 Americans have been killed in Israel, with 11 still unaccounted for. Some of the missing are believed to be among the hundreds kidnapped and held by Hamas. Dramatic images at a rally in Times Square Thursday night, loved ones holding pictures of hostages.
We know in every generation we fight back until we win.
Biden wants about $100 billion to fund the wars, arm Taiwan against China, and fortify the U.S.-Mexico border. According to a Quinnipiac University poll released this week, 55% of voters think the number of migrants seeking sanctuary in the U.S. is a crisis. 76% think supporting Israel is in America's interest, and 65% think the same of Ukraine. But it's up to Congress to approve the funding.
You can't buy friends, you can't buy loyalty.
The House still has no speaker, and that means Congress can't pass any legislation, including President Biden's proposed aid package. In Washington, yeah. Caroline Shively, Fox News.
In other news, demonstrations are being held in several nations over the Israeli war with Hamas. Fox News correspondent Steve Harrigan has more from Beirut.
What started as a day of rage against Israel has spiraled into protests around the world. In Turkey, Palestinian supporters launched fireworks and burned Israeli and American flags as they faced off with police in front of the Israeli consulate in Istanbul.
It is war crimes against humanity, so we should be standing with the people in Gaza.
In Jordan, anti-Israel and anti-U.S. protesters clashed with police outside Israel's embassy, throwing water bottles and rocks and setting fires.
We condemn the strike of Israel against the Palestinian people.
Tense moments in Greece as riot police pushed back before tens of thousands tried to march on the Israeli embassy in Athens. And in the North African country of Algeria, thousands took to the streets of the capital, chanting and demanding an end to the bombing of Gaza.
Where is the United Nations? Where are the Arabs? Do something.
While protesters have gotten close to U.S. embassies, a Marine who fought during the deadly attack on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi says U.S. assets should be okay for now.
We have time to plan, and we also have most of our embassies, like in Beirut, are in a country that has a standing army, a good police force, and under international law, they are there to protect the Americans as well and the American property.
The U.S. Embassy here now telling American citizens to make plans to get out now while flights are still operating. In Beirut, Lebanon, Steve Harrigan, Fox News.
Now let's turn to the new chaos on Capitol Hill. It's day 17 with no Speaker of the House. And now we've learned the man filling in as temporary Speaker has threatened to quit. ABC's Liz Landers is here with the details.
This morning, Congressman Jim Jordan is vowing to take his bid for House Speaker back to the floor for a third round of voting.
I'm still running for Speaker, and I plan to go to the floor and get the votes and win this race.
But a meeting last night with the holdouts in his party failed to change any minds. Jordan's other plan already failed. He floated giving the temporary speaker, Congressman Patrick McHenry, more power to buy Jordan the time to change people's minds, but talks reportedly ended in a screaming match.
I'm opposed to it, and a lot of us feel the same way.
Oh, hell no. No.
ABC News has learned McHenry threatened to quit if his colleagues tried to give him more power outside of his caretaker role, which he took on after former Speaker Kevin McCarthy was ousted.
Some other alternative here is something that I believe is unconstitutional and not conform with House rules. Furthermore, that I would not participate.
In the meantime, Congress remains paralyzed, unable to take up President Biden's request for Israel and Ukraine war funding, all while another potential government shutdown looms next month.
In Washington, Liz Landers, ABC News.
Congressman Jordan has scheduled a news conference this morning before the third round of voting begins.
Well, now to former President Donald Trump and the surprise turn in Georgia's election interference case. Trump's one-time attorney, Sidney Powell, who claimed Venezuela and Hugo Chavez, who is dead, by the way, was behind Trump's loss. Sidney Powell suddenly pleading guilty yesterday and now agreeing to cooperate with prosecutors. So what does that mean for Trump? Here's Aaron Katarski with more.
Sidney Catherine Powell.
She was at the center of Donald Trump's effort to overturn his 2020 loss, publicly pushing outlandish claims of election fraud and privately meeting with the former president inside the White House. But tonight, just one day before her trial was set to begin, Sidney Powell pleading guilty and agreeing to cooperate with prosecutors.
Ms. Powell, do you understand the charges that are against you here today? I do.
Powell spread the false conspiracy theory Georgia election machines were controlled by Venezuela, even pointing a finger at the country's former dictator, Hugo Chavez, who was dead.
This was exported from Venezuela and by Maduro and by Mr. Chavez. This is the consummate foreign interference in our election.
In an Oval Office meeting on December 18, 2020, Powell allegedly suggesting Trump name her special counsel to investigate election fraud. In that same meeting, Trump and his team allegedly weighed seizing voting machines, even declaring martial law. As part of her plea deal, Powell is now required to testify against her co-defendants, including the former president.
Coming up on the second half of the newscast, Brewer Federal Credit Union donated thousands of dollars to support food insecurity around the state.
We'll hear how as Good Morning Maine continues.
At WKIT in the 90s, things were a little different. Now we take The Rock very seriously. Still clowning around decades later. 100.3 WKIT. WKIT HD, Brewer, Bangor.
Bindi Irwin. She's faced pain and intense fatigue for years, and she says doctors dismissed it. Now this morning, she reveals what she did and the procedure that finally helped change everything for her. It's what every woman should know. This morning on Good Morning America.
Mesothelioma is more than a ravaging illness. It is a disease that can ruin a family's finances and is never the victim's fault. The law offices of Joe Bornstein has been fighting and winning for Maine families for nearly 50 years, and we've collected over $500 million for injured Mainers. If you or a loved one is a victim of mesothelioma or asbestos-related lung cancer, call Joe today for a free case evaluation and to learn about your family's legal rights. Dial 207-CALL-JOE or online at joebornstein.com.
Fall into amazing savings during Flex Deals Fall Factory Authorized Sale. Rake in serious deals on all styles and models. Choose from our huge selection of fabric and leather, reclining and stationary furniture, including Flex Deals Latitude, South Haven, and Wynwood collections, and all crafted with Flex Deals exclusive lifetime warranted Blue Steel Spring. Prices are falling, so hurry in today for cool savings. Fall in love at Flex Deals Factory Authorized Sale.
Dorsey Furniture, Route 1A Holden. Live beautifully, my friends.
Every night is pizza night at Dragonfire Pizza, from wings, salads, and sides to our specialty wood-fired pizzas. You'll find everything you need to satisfy any craving by the slice or by the pie. A little slice of heaven is waiting for you at Dragonfire Pizza, Mill Mall, Ellsworth.
You're watching ABC 7 Bangor.
Welcome back, everyone. Today is Friday, October 20th, 2021. Oh, my gosh. Now I'm like 2 years behind. 2023. Where did that come from?
A couple weeks ago, you thought it was November 2021. Oh, no, I'm fine with it not being 2021 again. We don't need a repeat.
That's bad. Ugh. It's also Information Overload Day. You'll like this one.
As the name suggests, this day is for taking a step back from the amount of information we're faced with on a daily basis. From social media to online news to emails and text messages, we're constantly bombarded with information. This day was created in 2009 to raise awareness about the negative effects that so much information can have on a person's mind and body.
It can stress you out. Just keeping up with text, reading the news these days.
I mean, apps are designed to keep us addicted to them. That constant scroll feature where there's new stuff and it never stops.
And they'll just keep giving you more and more and more.
That was designed for you to stay on the app and not want to do other things. So your attention is being monetized. Yeah. So just keep that in mind if you feel like overwhelmed because you're being taken advantage of.
It will stress you out. I've gotten really good at taking my phone and putting it down somewhere and leaving it and going away and doing things. It drives people crazy because they're trying to get in touch with me. We're so used to getting instant access to people these days.
I don't leave the house without my phone. That's kind of my generation.
Yeah. Well, I bring it with me wherever I go, but I'm good at like maybe leaving it in the car if I go somewhere. Yeah. But it's always there if I need to reach somebody or they need to reach me. But otherwise, I'll be scrolling around. I found myself scrolling around looking at stuff and then
I'm the same way.
Stress you out.
Yeah, people get upset at me because it takes me a couple hours or days to respond to texts, but I'm the type of person where if it's not urgent, I have so much other stuff on my mind and I ask my friends and family, just please forgive me.
Yeah, understand. Yeah. So today's a day to think about all that. Maybe unplug a little bit yourself.
Yeah.
It'd be good for you.
Yep.
All right, on this day in history, back in 1803, the U.S. Senate approved the Louisiana Purchase. Got a lot of land for not a lot of money.
It's crazy to think about.
Yeah. In 1910, a baseball with a cork center was used for the first time at a World Series game. In 1947, the House Un-American Activities Committee opened hearings into alleged communist influence within the motion picture industry.
What year was that?
1947.
Huh. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, that's a whole conversation, too.
Yeah. People were blacklisted. It turned into a whole thing. Everybody was really worried about communism infiltrating.
Right.
All right, you can read this part if you want.
In 1973, Queen Elizabeth was in attendance as the Sydney Opera House opened its doors. The iconic building was declared a World Heritage Site and cost over $100 million to construct. In 2003, a 40-year-old man went over Niagara Falls without safety devices and survived.
He ended up getting a ticket for like criminal trespassing or illegally doing a stunt or whatever.
Right. Well, if you die in front of a bunch of people, that's traumatic.
Not too smart. Yeah. People used to do that, though. They used to get in like barrels. They had these things every now and then.
It sounds like a Houdini thing.
That's exactly what it was. Yeah. They'd go over the falls and they'd attract a lot of people.
Yeah.
Some people lived, some people didn't.
Right.
And apparently some people are still doing it.
I know. It's funny how information overload. Things have changed in the past couple hundred years. People used to go attend, executions as their as their entertainment of the day. And to me, that seems similarly morbid.
Yeah. Like a Daredevil show. You never know what's going to happen. You know, you hope he survives, but a little part of you is like, the crash would be cool too, It's true.
Yeah,
it's
it is. Yeah. Humans are morbidly fascinated with things.
Yeah.
Okay, today's birthdays include rapper Snoop Dogg, who's 52. Personally, I already wished him a happy birthday, so I'm ahead of the game.
Yeah. Actor. Oh my, why'd they get that picture of John?
Actor John Krasinski from The Office is 44. You don't like Handsome John?
No. I mean, it's fine, whatever, but...
Put some clothes on.
Clothes on, man. He's in his birthday suit almost on his birthday.
Yeah, he's kind of naked. Yeah. Okay, this is also the birthday of Vice President Kamala Harris.
They picked the funny one for her, too.
I know, she's in the shadow of Biden in this one. That's funny. Okay. We got a bunch of birthdays today of big people.
Happy birthday to them. Get all three of them together for a conversation. That'd be interesting. They probably do just fine too.
I'd see that. I'd pay money to see that.
Just as long as what's his name puts his shirt on.
Right.
Just, maybe I'm just jealous because I don't look like that. I don't know.
Maybe me too. Yeah.
Okay. He's a great actor though.
I don't know. Was that from The Last of Us?
I don't know. There was 13 hours he was in. That was right. pretty good.
Yeah.
I don't know.
He's gotten with the serious movies. I just liked Jim from The Office.
Yeah, he's funny.
Yeah.
So, hey, the weather going to be partly cloudy today. We'll see a little sun, too, though.
Yeah, there you go. Here's Devin Biggs.
And thank you very much, Craig and Emma. Happy Friday. Your first weather forecast brought to you by Blind Faith Tattoo. With over 25 years of experience, we are fluent in all styles, including traditional and fine line tattoos. Stop by for a free consultation from one of our friendly expert tattoo artists. We offer a fast turnaround, and walk-ins are always welcome. Let's get into things this morning. And again, watching clouds are developing. Maybe a few returns, maybe some showers in the northern parts of the state as well. We'll watch for a little bit more development to the south coming up later on today, as all of us will get in on the action coming up later today, and especially overnight sign with a decent amount of rainfall on the way over the next few days. I'll need to keep an eye on from this system to the south and this system off to the west as well. Both of these will be moving in our direction. So futurecast for today, increasing clouds, some showers possible late in the afternoon, and we'll have better chances for rain overnight tonight, especially into the daytime tomorrow. As for the winds, not too bad from time to time, roughly out of the south at around 10 to 15 miles per hour sustained, with gusts up to 25 miles per hour possible in a few spots. We'll see that back off a little bit later on tonight, but might pick up a little bit again, especially as we head towards Saturday afternoon. So for today, lower 60s, mostly cloudy, some afternoon showers, and a south wind getting up to around 25 miles per hour at times. Overnight time, middle 50s for the overnight low, rain likely, areas of dense fog can't be ruled out, and an east wind at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Hourly forecast for the rest of the morning and afternoon period, a lot of clouds. We had showers late in the day with temperatures in the 60s. Your full 5-day forecast is coming up. Craig and Emma.
All right, thank you, Devin. Well, Brewer Federal Credit Union gave a big boost to the Holden Food Pantry chefs in honor of the 75th International Credit Union Day. That's a mouthful. On Thursday, the credit union presented the food pantry with a check worth $8,000. It's all part of the Maine Credit Union's Ending Hunger campaign in Maine, which raises hundreds of thousands of dollars every year. All the proceeds raised help support food cupboards and pantries all across the state.
We provide the foods, and we're fortunate that we can provide foods that need to be refrigerated or frozen so that we have a wider variety to provide for people.
Well, Chefs in Holden is a smaller food pantry that serves around 30 families a week. If you're interested in volunteering at Chefs, you can contact the Holbrook School in Holden. That's some local people helping out some local people right there.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's a lot harder for food pantries to be able to carry those things that need to be refrigerated and perishables. So, wow.
Boy, I'll tell you what, the credit unions, too, they've been doing this for years. They take that Ending Hunger campaign seriously. They've raised boatloads of money for the hungry in Maine. So
cool. Keep
up the good work.
Absolutely. All right, still to come here this morning, Tyler Cruz will have the latest with sports.
Don't go away.
It's another exciting year of high school football in the state of Maine. Get out and support your home team and be looking for the ABC7 Sports Blitz crew. You can get a free Sports Blitz t-shirt, then watch Sports Blitz during ABC7 News at 11 every Friday night during the football season. Blitz shirts courtesy of Coldbrook Mitsubishi, Boynton's Greenhouse, Coastal Auto Parts, Family Pet Connection and Grooming, Greg's Auto Repair, Hardy's Motorsports, The Bankery, and West Front Market.
I got hurt in a car accident, and I'm worried the insurance company is trying to take advantage of me.
Don't get burned by the insurance company. Fight fire with fire and call the twos.
We'll turn up the heat on the insurance company. We'll make them pay you all the money you deserve.
I fought fire with fire and called the twos. Lowry & Associates got me $300,000 for my car accident. Now that's hot.
We win for you.
If you're hurt in an accident, what do you do? Call 222-2222.
Are you ready to light it up, Bangor? Experience the all-new Hot Wheels Monster Trucks Live Glow Party, featuring outrageous Monster Trucks action, including the electrifying freestyle motocross, laser light show, and the fire-breathing transforming robot, Transaurus. Plus the Crash Zone pre-show party before each performance, and save up to 50% on kids' tickets. Come watch your favorite Hot Wheels Monster Truck toys come to life October 20th through 22nd at Cross Insurance Center in Bangor. Tickets available at Ticketmaster.com.
Ready for that new kitchen? Get inspired by the complete in-store showroom displays at Hammond Lumber. Your dream kitchen begins when you bring your vision to Hammond Lumber Company.
Welcome back in, everyone. Thank you for staying with us. Let's start on the basketball court. The college hoop season is just a few weeks away, with Maine women's hoops tipping off on November 6th. Black Bears being picked to finish second in the America East preseason coaches poll. We heard from head coach Amy Vachon and fifth-year guard Ann Simon at Media Day on Thursday. They're all excited to get going with 97%, that's not a joke, of their scoring coming back from a season ago. The Black Bears are deep and they're experienced. So Coach Vachon is stressing a selfless, team-first mindset heading into the year.
The word we're using a lot this year is selflessness. You know, roles are going to change. They may change game to game. You know, we have a lot of players that can play, and a lot of people have gotten better, and a lot of people are competing for roles. And so it's competitive, you know, and that's good.
That is good. Maine is returning their whole starting five, including two previous America East Players of the Year, Adriana Smith and Ann Simon. Simon missed most of the year to injury last season, but is choosing to come back for her fifth year of eligibility for some unfinished business. And according to her, that decision was definitely a no-brainer.
No, it was definitely an easy decision to come back. Obviously, the past 4 years haven't been the outcome that I wanted, so just having that one more chance, that one more opportunity to come back to Maine and hopefully finish what we want as a team.
Anytime you bring back a player of Ann's caliber, that's going to help your team. And not only that, but her leadership and her selflessness. And I mean, you heard her. The first thing she said was she wants to win a championship. You know, I guarantee if you ask.
Certainly looking forward to getting back up in the pit. Let's go to some high school soccer now. Brewer boys soccer start their playoff push next week against Brunswick. Nazar Ryan Sudol reports a late push and an improved sense of team identity has the Witches confident heading in.
We can compete with anyone in our league, and we're looking to make a run this year.
After starting near the bottom of the standings, Brewer boys soccer has rallied and head into the postseason with a head full of steam.
We're always talking about peaking at the end of the season. That's what we did this year, and you know, it's great to have that momentum going into playoffs.
The Witches are the sixth seed in A North and had four wins and a draw in their final eight games, a product of their commitment to improving their on-field chemistry.
I think at first we were struggling getting the ball from one side to the other, but we started working on it more in practice. As we started moving it more, it started working out better for us.
It also helps that the first part of their season was filled with opponents near the top of the playoff bracket. The rough start was well worth the experience.
We had some tough matchups at the start of the year, and we came together as a team and got better and worked hard, and we're at a good spot right now.
Playing the harder teams first got us like a sense of like difficulty and like that we can play against those teams.
In turn, the Witches hung tough with their opponents the rest of the way. A one-goal loss to fifth seed Edward Little sticks out, especially with how the Eddies fared against top seed Lewiston.
I mean, I think that we should have gone out at least with a tie against Edward Little, and they just happened to beat Lewiston 5-3, which is huge. If we can compete with them and they can compete with them, then we can compete with anybody.
Now the Witches prepare to face the three seed and defending state champs Brunswick in a rematch of last year's quarterfinals. The Witches played them to a 2-2 draw this year, so the confidence is much higher this time around.
Offensively, they're really skilled. They have a lot of facilitators and a lot of goal scorers, and we just got to stop them, shut them down, and we'd like to get our revenge, and you know, it's a big team to beat, but I think we can do it.
I just feel like if we work together as a team and just play for each other, then we can pull through and get the win.
In Brewer, I'm Ryan Sudol, ABC 7, Fox 22 Sports.
Thanks for that, Ryan. Wishing them luck. Let's stay with some soccer now. And as we now know, playoffs are here. We have some preliminary matchups kicking off on Friday. Here are some of the ones in our area. For B North girls, Belfast visits Old Town at 3 p.m. In D North boys, Jonesport Beals and Penobscot Valley battle at 5 p.m. Dexter comes to Orono at 3:30 p.m. And Orono heads to Central for boys at 3 p.m. All of these games are tomorrow. Wishing all of those teams best of luck as they contend for a state title. To some hockey now. It's been a long week off, but the Boston Bruins starting up a four-game road trip late Thursday Thursday night in San Jose. The Bees will also be making stops in Los Angeles, Anaheim, and Chicago. It's been so far so good for the Bruins to start the season. They are off to a 2-0 start after wins over the Blackhawks and Nashville. Former UMaine star Jeremy Swayman has enjoyed a great start to his NHL career so far, named to the All-Rookie team 2 years ago and then being a big part of the success last year. And on Tuesday, former Bruins goalie Tuukka Rask was in Portland, and we asked him what he likes the most about Swayman's game.
I love watching him play. I had a chance to play with him a little bit, practice with him quite a bit on the ice. He's a very talented goalie. I'm really looking forward to watching him this year because, you know, it's going to be a big year for him.
He's not the only one that likes watching him play. That's all the time we have for sports. We'll be right back after the break.
In the beautiful town of Belfast, you'll discover a world of alpaca, the blue alpaca. At our ranch location, you can interact with these amazing animals and enjoy the beautiful Maine outdoors with your very own alpaca walk. Visit our website to book your alpaca walk and experience all the joy and beauty that comes with it. Shop at our downtown Belfast location or online and take advantage of our free nationwide shipping. You'll be ready for a comfortable, fashionable, and fun summer. The blue alpaca. Feel the difference.
Mesothelioma is more than a ravaging illness. It is a disease that can ruin a family's finances and is never the victim's fault. The law offices of Joe Bornstein has been fighting and winning for Maine families for nearly 50 years, and we've collected over $500 million for injured Mainers. If you or a loved one is a victim of mesothelioma or asbestos-related lung cancer, call Joe today for a free case evaluation and to learn about your family's legal rights. Dial 207-CALL-JOE or online at joebornstein.com.
Arrival of the fall season and cooler air settling in for much of the country, many Americans are revamping their wardrobes. But the temptation to buy that new sweater or coat can leave old clothes behind, adding to problems of waste and emissions that contribute to climate change. ABC's chief meteorologist Ginger Z has more.
It's the season of boots, sweaters, and all the autumn fashion vibes. But as you sip your pumpkin spice, a good reminder. Fashion has the third largest carbon footprint behind only food and construction. All those fresh looks make up 10% of annual carbon emissions worldwide. Elizabeth Klein, author and Columbia University professor of consumerism and fashion policy, has some key advice to shop more sustainably.
I think the first thing that people can do is to just start asking more questions. You know, there are a lot of companies out there that are trying to lessen their environmental impact, improve their social impact. And once you start to look, you'll find more companies like that.
Klein said those companies that are actually environmentally friendly can back up their claims, explaining what they're doing to make their product green. Sustainable brands can bring a higher price tag, but there are also affordable options. Your best bet? Buy secondhand. That reduces an item's carbon impact immediately. And renting clothes might be a good option for special events. Klein says be intentional about what you buy because most of our fashion ends up in a landfill.
Don't use your ability to donate clothes as an excuse to just buy a bunch of stuff that you're going to throw out at the end of the season because there's no guarantee that that garment is going to be reused.
With this Climate Minute, I'm Ginger Z.
Looks like a lot of sweater weather is coming up. For more on what we can expect over the weekend ahead, here's Devin Biggs.
All righty, Craig and Emma, thank you very much. Your full weather forecast brought to you by Blind Faith Tattoo. With over 25 years of experience, we are fluent in all styles, including traditional and fine line tattoos. Stop by for a free consultation from one of our friendly expert tattoo artists. We offer a fast turnaround and walk-ins are always welcome. All right, let's get into things this morning. And again, clouds will move again, mainly from the south going toward the north and also from the west going toward the east. Maybe a few returns in the northern parts of the the state too, with maybe a few showers that could be developing in a few areas. We'll be watching for more chances for showers a little bit later this afternoon, but especially overnight tonight. Let's break this down right now. We have all this activity right here with this system right about in here, tracking from the west going toward the east, and another little system right about in here that's going to be tracking off towards the north. And both of these combined will give us a decent amount of rainfall, possibly up to 2 inches of rainfall over the next few days before we're all finished up. Let's break all this down with Futurecast. So clouds will be on the increase today, maybe a few peaks of sunshine from time to time. Later this afternoon to the evening period, the rain starts moving slowly but surely, with better opportunities for rain as we head after midnight towards tomorrow morning. So a lot of rainfall will be on the way. Some heavy downpours cannot be ruled out either, but notice a few breaks from time to time too before another wave gets going as we head towards Saturday evening. And that will also continue into parts of Sunday morning as well, as that area low pressure continues to track off towards the east. As for the rainfall, it's a little bit like this. So between now and at least Monday morning when this all wraps up, maybe up to 1 to 2 inches of rain before we're all finished up, maybe locally up to 3 inches of rain in a few spots. So maybe some flash flooding in a few areas before we're all finished up. Make sure you're watching for that through the weekend time frame. Otherwise, though, gusty winds as well, reaching up to around 25 miles per hour at times this afternoon. It'll actually back off a little while overnight tonight, but as we head towards tomorrow afternoon, gusty winds up to maybe 20 miles per hour will be possible yet again, especially later in the afternoon period for your Saturday. Our average high temperature is 57 degrees. We'll reach for the lower 60s today and also tomorrow. We have 50s on the way Sunday into Monday, with middle 50s at that point, upper 50s Tuesday, and lower 60s as we head towards Wednesday and also in your Thursday. For today, lower 60s, mostly cloudy, some afternoon showers possible, and a south wind getting up to around 25 miles per hour. Overnight time, middle 50s, rain likely, areas of dense fog possible, and an east wind at around 5 to 10 miles per hour. Here's tomorrow, lower 60s, rain likely, some morning fog as well, and an east wind at around 5 to 10 miles per hour, but the winds will start to pick up later in the afternoon period as well. Here's a look at extended forecast brought to you by Blind Faith Tattoo. So rain likely again for your Sunday with highs in the mid-50s. We'll remain in the mid-50s for your Monday with a lot of sunshine, and mostly sunny again for your Tuesday, highs in the upper 50s.